You've got a pretty amazing boy yourself. Shame you don't spend time getting to know him. Don't go on. I do have a life, you know. You're wasting your life, Frankie. The drugs, the rotten men. One day, if you decide to sort things out, you could live here with Tom and me, voluntarily, not just because the court orders you to. Yeah, yeah, one day, maybe. Tommy's mum sniffs, then scratches at the scab by her mouth. He can see her ribs suck in and out when she breathes. Her face bones look sharp too, as though they might cut through her skin one day, then more of her would bleed. Her pink top has a sparkly star on the front, not something a mum should wear. Mila's mum comes back out onto her deck. She has a big mug with her, and she wobbles a bit while she walks. I might go over there sometime, have a good chat with her, says Frankie. I'm not sure she'd welcome that at the moment. She's got a lot going on, probably doesn't need any more. Her big kids have gone. It's just Max now and Tama. She's probably missing the older ones, says Grandma. Tommy makes a noise so Grandma will hear him. She smiles and looks happy that she can end the chat with his mum. Oh, Tom, come and help me hang the washing out, dear. When the washing is on the line, Tommy watches Mila's mum tip her ashtray into the outside bin and put the kitchen rubbish on top of the butts. Then she squashes the empty wine cask and puts it in the incinerator under some newspaper. She thinks the things she does are a secret, but everyone knows. Grandma has tried to help, but Esther says she's got it all under control. Max needs her. She tidies herself up for him and Tama. She'll make it all work. She bangs the door shut and turns the music even louder.